This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
Another beautiful morning down here in Kampala and of course Uganda to be precise, 17th of December 2019. The day is a Tuesday and I would like to use this opportunity to say good morning to you. It is yet another day to wake up, shine, dream, and then of course go ahead and make sure that you do dreams come true. And away from that, we'll be welcoming you to 2 hours of nothing but infotainment. Today on the show, it's gonna be jam-packed as we'll be letting you know on the news coming in from the climatical change, or what you could call the weather. And we understand that we have some news coming in that apparently we could be waving goodbye to the wet days. Anytime from now, we could be getting into our dry season. Now, how ready are you to, of course, revert yourself from the wet season to the dry season that is going to be happening a couple of weeks away from that? That is another interesting way for you to get ready and geared up for 2024. It could start up with some heat coming in, and we hope that heat does not transform itself into your pockets during January. But anyway, moving away from that, we'll be taking you into some news that is making headlines across the country as far as an accident is concerned due to the heavy downpour. We're giving you some details coming in from that particular one. And later on, away from that, a very interesting conversation or topic that we shall be attaining some a little bit of, you know, discussions. But also, we are not sure how it's going to end at the end of the day. It has to end. How do you tell her she's fat? How do you tell your woman, God damn! That's a lot of weight, baby. You need to cut it down. Hey, it's going to be an interesting one. All you need to do is make sure you get in touch with us on our personal handles. That's on Twitter at @Aine-TinaFierce1, as well as Willis Daily. Not forgetting our TV station platforms. That is Urban Television for Facebook and at Urban TV Uganda. Head over there and give us a comment. And of course, we can't wait for the studio lines to be open, whereby we shall be having some of the ladies will be telling us, how do you prefer your man? Or how do you prefer someone to tell you that, babe, oh my God, that's a lot of weight. Wait, and does that question even mean anything? And why do women actually take offense when you tell them that they are growing fat? It's going to be an interesting 2 hours of infotainment, so keep it down. And let's do this. Tina Fierce and Willis, good morning to you guys.
Good morning. Morning.
Are you fantastic?
Beautiful.
That's great.
You?
Oh, I'm awesome. I'm good, man. I'm looking forward to Christmas every single day of my life. I don't know why, but yeah, I'm doing that.
Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Willis, how about you?
I'm fine. And I'm very fine, but as usual, I celebrate people. Mm-hmm. And today I'd like to celebrate my border guy. He's called Abdu. Mm-hmm. Abdu Kumacha, Awada Nyumiza, Abdu Muchiga. Naibu ayogera nanga, ayogera nanga mu Uganda.
Wait, they are Wachiga who are Muslim?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
But there must be like 2 out of 10.
Okay.
Ah, that work about
me.
He's a very good guy. You know, he's the only guy I allow to, you know, speed up when he's trying to ride me. I think overspeeding is really about trust. When you trust someone and say, Abudu, nienda kwa office, ndireti.
Yeah, hey, that's true.
Kwata mwenye jaji kudemu na ajivuga na ajivuga kwa office. So I'd like to celebrate Abudu today. Very hardworking guy. And, you know, other border guys who are as trustworthy as him. Abudu is a guy you call up and say, Abudu, you don't give him money, he brings it. Whether you have or don't have, Aizuru.
Actually, let us just celebrate those border guys.
Hey, those real guys border guys who...
We send for weird things. Hey. Hello? Again, I'm Katare on the bring me food. Bring
me to enjoyment. Not to get enjoyment.
Joyagara.
But also on that note, I want to send shout out to some border guys. Ngayemu abawa kubanja.
Hey!
Wabirane air time we kuba. Ngayemu abawa inasi omu tumye mkatari.
Akubipinga.
Mkubila. Abonema tumye tumideko. Ngayemu ambi abelao. Ngayemu lisawa tabila na sente zimaramu nsao.
Sina okash.
Sina okash.
Buliwamu gama nefila enjoyment.
Sina okash.
Sina okash.
abudunga
tetunnemanya bulungi ngaomugamba neta enjoyment ha bosi nga nzitute mukibina nomugate
kwegamba ye yagoberera ebigambo bya Museveni bagula mubiri n'abakazi babiri
ali mukibina bingi
When we celebrate all the boda boda men who learned how to bathe, ne moza ne ko jacket za mwe banda e mwatu kola chirunji nyo. We are thankful. We don't know tuchija ku ntobo yo mutima. Abasajja ba boda nako zino bana aba. Jacket tebacha joza mulundi gumu.
Toyinza butana aba ngoli mu rain season. Tetsoboka afazalo jakuba o just unabo automatically. Well we bintu byola biladala nga they are very hard to move away from.
So January
to gamba January yo ha.
Bagena jinafu ya.
Allah. Musana kugenda kwaka.
Otula ku boda ngelekana. Tumaye na batomera.
Ne yarabo lien kuba mkuba jacket ta jambale mirunde ebili so he has no option rather than you know hanging it or washing it. He has no option rather than you know cleaning up himself. So sanganga ali clean. Ne boda zili clean. Na ilinda January mganda
wangu. So Abdu today is for him and you know for every boda guy that just holds it down for us and he just does that for us.
Okay, moving away from the border, border guys. Now, like I did mention earlier on in my introduction, we are going to be having a bit of a climatic change. The news coming in, of course, from the meteorological department is that we shall be shifting from the wet season to the dry season a couple of weeks from now. Now, how ready are you guys?
Huh? How many?
They just didn't specify a number of weeks, but they said a couple of weeks. So I'm anticipating up to maybe the first week of January.
First week of January. Yeah. Then when do we get rains again?
Ha. By natural as to say, if
you have your Fabina,
be a commia of January. Never to get money ready for the transition.
Climate change is something that a conversation we need to talk about
really, really,
very, very seriously. Kubanga, for me, I look at the weather personally. I, of course, respect the views of professionals who say the winds are coming left, right. Then, Nebawa winds are manyaga bakazi.
Monsoon wind.
Sina windy. No guy, oba nene, oba chi. You could go and get jam, we're gonna
pull winds. Aha,
wind in a zina mania.
Hey, and so what they limu, monsoon winds.
Hey, monsoon zezo, zive no mo India,
what is Indian Ocean, then a zigila was chi.
So I respect their, you know, professional opinions about that, but I like to look at climate change at a personal level. No guarantee, Nzebanji Giza, or I just see catch up at a kamocha young ambanga. Ntienkuba go eve ginger, again, Akutonia. Bweva mu West tegenda tonya. So every time we end up a chilebo echitinga nyimirira enkuba egenda kutonya. So yeah. So climate change, I look at climate change like that. If you look at the rains in the past few days, it's been a hot rain, not cold. Like it rains, but it's not that cold of I need to
cut
door. It's humid. So the next few rains, I predict, in my personal opinion, that it's going to be hot rains and probably headed into the second week of January to Jabanga to Zeyunga Kakocha and Msao Kauli.
Ah, Neda. Genda kuna fuya January.
January, Chavoli, and away soon. January.
Let me ask, Atanga Kubuzango Musiru, why do we complain that January is hard? Yet, the entire year we have been earning the same amount of money.
The corporate world has been spoiled, sort of like that last born in your family. That your bosses, some bosses actually give two salaries. They torture their employees to give them December and January salary. Olina kuwa omugugugwa sente. Gweno sanyuka ni wakweza December ni January. Notamanti January mieze meka.
Exactly.
Some employers pay their employees on 15th of December.
Atabo bakoli
for both months, December and January.
Yes.
Bakoli midwe.
Atene chidala. Gawe ni siku wakami last born. December is the last month of the year.
So
that is why it has a special name attached to it. Dirty December.
Drinksember.
So you spend, you drink, you want to, you know, be like, okay, finally I've made it to the end of the year. Now in that confusion and lack of, you know, self-control.
And then also the traveling, most of us travel to the villages.
Yes.
So in traveling to the village, you're like, sivaddeyo mwaka mulamba nimekudayo na kanyama
nogule
mbuzi bbiri
nogule omugati. If you know that you want to travel in December, you start saving up from January.
We don't know.
You see, you don't know that you're going.
Everybody am in December, mzee inakuwira ngoncha inoga.
How can you not know?
At natural, we need to accept saving is not really an African thing. We are just trying to adopt
it. Kutomeza banno.
No, but it's the truth, Tina.
Kubagwe this January agenda bera anonga ali wanonga bagamba banaye abana kujemuli keep your girlfriend.
Ngenda kubera wano era bana January is a very tough month for people who have hot girlfriends in Zimbabwe. Ndi akabitani.
Hot girlfriends and not dry pockets.
Exactly. But ngenda kubera, but saving culture is not something that, you know, we have grown to have as Africans. It is something we are trying to adopt. And it is a tough thing, I must tell you. Mm-hmm. Imagine you go savings akakade kukamu. Mbubuoli yao chini nze sina biyoli. Kwa wili sinakubile sinagamba. Ho! E jinja wanange chikute. Mbuka hiya nanga ni mulivu.
Olavo, ndayo mkopu.
Mwaiya, mwoli yao mkopu.
Is it possible?
Hey, otawazi tuka email.
Ota ndiko kuba calculations. Noga, if I remove this 1M, and then I do this card gig, then I bring this 500, Derek will pay me my debt.
And then I will have money.
Ah, no kwata mzimba.
Ngowomi.
Nezikuocha. Mba nezikuocha.
But anyway, what I'm trying to say is that, you know, as you're getting to enjoy your December, the festive season is around the corner. People are going to be traveling to the villages, spending time with families. At the end of the day, you need to budget yourself and, of course, make sure that you're not among those crying faces during the tough month of January. For those of you that will be crying faces, we shall be here every single day of January for 3 months to tell you that God is with you.
And he loves you.
Moving away from that, I want to get into some starting news. Now, apparently, 21 people have been injured in an accident. Now, details coming in this story show that at least 21 people were injured yesterday morning after a bus they were traveling in got involved in an accident. According to the police, the bus lost control after the morning drizzle and skidded off the road before overturning. The Rwenzori West Regional Police Commander, Lukanga Kayondo, told New Vision by telephone that the bus registration number UBB461B was traveling from Kasese to Kampala when it got an accident at Kaswa Trading Center on the Kabarore Chenjojo Road. The victims are admitted to the hospital. Three of them lost a hand each. Kayondo said he blamed the accident on reckless driving, adding drivers should be very careful. The roads are smooth, but it does not guarantee speeding. Kayondo said they had installed more checkpoints and whoever will be found breaking the traffic rules will be arraigned in court. This goes back to what I was talking about yesterday. At the end of the day, you as a passenger, you have the right to tell your driver that munange, you're over speeding, it's been a rainy morning, you need to slow down. You're not in a rush hour to get anywhere.
Remember that song, Genda Mpola?
Yeah.
Speedy Controle. That one. I think we need to have it playing in Kampala town and in bus taxi parks around this time, because we all know what the bus companies do around this time. We andi vuze route satu, kati alikuvuga route mkaka. Muluna kulumu. Na imagine, you enter a car, era chogamba chitu, faba ino kwebedida. O ingira moto kwa notu nulia driver nga asuma gira. Yasuza avuga, asibia avuga. Chokana wagenda kutwala on that same distance. Mkube etonya, ama kubo gali too smooth, e moto kegenda mule merida, you end up doing.
That's true.
Be careful.
And to yaga la kufam Christmas, never know. Yes, we are Nikomao. But moving away from that, a man kills three children and he's on the run. Now, the police in Chiboga district are hunting for a man suspected to have killed three children, all from one family. The Wamala Regional Police Commander, that is Bob Kagaruru, told the New Vision by phone on Monday that so far four accomplices have been arrested, with two of them likely to be charged with murder. Now, Bob said the suspect is a Mason who once worked for the children's parents. The children, whose father is only identified as Barije, were kidnapped last week from Kawanda Village in Ramata Town Council, and their bodies recovered on Sunday. He kidnapped the children and slaughtered them. He then asked for a ransom, and when 500,000 shillings was sent to him, he demanded for more 500,000 shillings Bob said, declining the revival of the name of the key suspect for fear of jeopardizing the investigations. Now, the RPC said they suspected the children aged between 4 and 8 were already dead by the time the kidnapper started asking for ransom.
This is where
I disagree with democracy.
Mm-hmm. Mm. You're right. Some people because do not even need to be arraigned in court. Mm. We do not need to start that nonsense of Simanya, innocent until proven guilty. I mean, if you have had evidence against you, your voice, the call they made to you, you're the person they sent the money to, why are you wasting my resources as a Ugandan to take him to Luzira? Huh?
Willis, why is it that you argue with democracy as far as this is concerned?
I disagree with democracy. Mm. Such nonsense will not happen in territorial rules.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Because, I mean, this guy asked for money. There's recordings of money being sent to him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There is proof that this guy had the children.
Yeah.
And, you know, for some reason, investigations is coming through. What do you want to investigate?
No, what investigating?
Who he was working for? That was torture the guy and he tells you.
And of course, it's very sad and very unfortunate that this family has to go through this tough trying times during the festive season. But away from that, there could be someone who will be enjoying the festive season with some chopsticks in her hands. That is, of course, Honorable Evelyn Annette. Now, IGG clears Honorable Annette for the UTL saga. Now, Irene Mulyagonja has dropped investigations into alleged abuse of office by State Minister for Finance in charge of investments and privatization, that is Evelyn Annette, in the controversial Uganda Telecom investment deals. Now, in a December 6th letter, Justice Mulyagonja notified Ms. Annette that the file had been closed after investigations found no case in the allegations. Justice Mulyagonja's letter reads in part, after preliminary investigations, the IGG has decided to discontinue any further investigations into the matter in line with Section 19, Subsection 2 of the Inspectorate Government Act 2002. Now, the IGG added, this is because we are satisfied that further investigations into the matter would be unnecessary and futile. According to the case, file has been closed. In the past few days, Ms. Annette said, from the onset, I always pushed hard to save UTL from liquidation. On the other hand, a network of corrupt individuals seeking to liquidate and share UTL assets picked on me for blackmail and slander. They extended their blackmail effort to institutions like IGG to waste taxpayers' money. I'm happy they have been defeated. They have been defeated and ashamed. They will be exposed too.
Mm. Wait, first. Okay, good for her. Yay, we're happy because, I mean, when it happened, we all were like, Bambi.
Our Annette.
Mm. Okay, we don't like her that much, but at that moment,
you and who?
I will get back to that one.
Yeah.
So, anyway, what's funny though is how she has been threatening to expose from the onset. She kept saying the mafia. Actually, I think the coin phrase started with her, mafia and Afoka mafia. Up to now, you have not yet found the time to explain.
No, I think for her,
as far as UTL is concerned, she named and shamed.
No, she did. She brought out names of, you know, the former ED of UTL. He, you know, involved
no,
the Attorney General.
Those are people she was accused.
As far as UTL is concerned, I feel like, you know, this is a plus for her because what she wanted was change in leadership, whatever it's called, of UTL, which did happen after.
No,
the
for me,
intervened.
I think that
you don't get it. The
I think that
she has
this investigation has done a disservice to Ugandans.
Mm-hmm.
There were allegations from her that there are mafias who are influencing and, you know, peddling with UTL
different institutions
and the IGG.
In the country.
Mm. So when she made that allegation, it's upon the IGG to investigate
and pull through.
You know, give they owe it to Ugandans for an explanation of who was she talking about.
Because
when you say that the case is closed
and it seems futile, I'm looking at you.
What do you mean futile? Omuntu wagamanti, they are mafias, and then you say, ah man, we haven't found anything, it's not going to be helpful, let's close it now. You're indirectly telling us that mafias are now pulling your strings.
Exactly.
You understand? So now Annette is right when she says that there are people who are blackmailing the office of the IGG.
So which means she has not got down to the bottom of the problem.
Yeah, so I,
we wanted to know these mafias, because if she had come out, put them out on blast,
for her as an individual,
she
can't come out and say so and so is a mafia, because one, she's a public figure, two, she's she's working for government, she's running a ministry, so she can't come out and officially say that these are the mafias. There are channels she has to go through.
IGG is the one that had to do
it. I think we're looking at this from different angles. The angle I'm taking is that we remember when the UTL saga broke out, you know? Annette was among the individuals that, you know, are forefronting the entire investigation and, you know, talking to the office of the IGG to come and do investigations as far as, you know, management is concerned at UTL. But then, nevertheless, part B of the story is that this guy, the Attorney General, you know, the former UTL boss, came out to say that, you know, Annette is involved in a couple of sagas here and there. And then Annette came out and said, if I'm involved in anything, I am willing to step aside for the IGG to investigate. If I am found guilty, then let me take whatever punishment will be available. And then this triggered the IGG to come through and do the investigation. Now, I believe what the IGG is trying to communicate is, after Annette had stepped aside for investigations, this is what happened. We found out that Annette is actually not
They
guilty.
Didn't find out.
No,
the IGG is saying they dropped the investigation.
But now here's the question.
They did not investigate.
You dropped the investigation after it has been
Did you see how you brought Olava Ngabo Achilese from the onset? Kakati wano, me that entire talk you just gave us stays with one thing. They were not investigating Annette as a person. They were investigating what? Who were they investigating? Just UTL and her claims, were they investigating her to find out if she has any backstory?
I think they were investigating her, but you see, you can't take her out of the story. You investigate
she's the story.
One, there are two things. I agree with you that she has, and Uganda has succeeded in the UTL saga. Yes, but her allegations that there are mafias who are, you know, messing around with UTL and her and the IGG's office, those still stand.
Exactly.
And the IGG owes it to us as Ugandans to say, look, let's investigate what mafias she's talking about.
Okay.
If you drop the investigations before you even investigate, predicting, because you're not God or a prophet, to say that this investigation, there's no one.
Well, I think it will be very unfair for us to say that, you know, the investigation was dropped even before it started.
I think that the IGG owes it to Ugandans to put this on you know, to table it in parliament, to ask Ugandans. Because for us, our representatives are in parliament. We have not said drop the investigation. Why are you dropping it?
No, my question is one. So yes, there was an investigation. It was dropped because they noticed it was futile. There was nothing. What was the investigation about in particular?
It was
the UTL saga and Annette.
It was the UTL and the Annette took a bribe. You know, there was a story that Annette, I think she was in Switzerland, and then she took a bribe as far as, you know, the UTL is concerned.
Yes.
And Annette said, I did not take this bribe. Actually, when I was in this country, I was doing ABCD. So let the IGG intervene. I'm going to step aside. If she finds out that I'm guilty, then, you know, I'll take charge.
See, that is right. My question is coming
That is the investigation that they were doing.
Yes.
But then they never did the real investigation.
That investigation they did, yes. And they probably found out she didn't take a bribe.
She's innocent, yes.
But you see, this is the same person who said they are mafias.
And that's why the investigation started.
We need to look for the mafias.
That's why it started.
But congratulations to you, Honorable Evelyn Annette, as far as this one is concerned. It's off the book. And indeed, you can enjoy your festive season with a smiling face. Moving away from that, let's take a quick look at some shout-outs coming in. My shout-out is going into the one and only Rafael Majeze. That is the Minister of Local Government. Now, the newly appointed Minister, Rafael Majeze, Ministry of Local Government, has brushed off critics who claim his inclusion on the list of new ministers as a political award. Critics claim that president's choices were informed by the success of the 2017 constitution amendment that repealed the 75-year age cap for presidential candidates that was mooted by Mr. Majeze. However, Mr. Majeze, who is also a member of parliament for Igala West in Bushenyi district, yesterday said the critics were only unfair to his 20 years of experience in politics. I regard that as an insult. This is an unfair comment because it implies that if I had not moved the bill, I would not qualify to be a minister, he said. Let us respect the appointing authority in terms of the choice. I think he had his parameters, which were objective regarding the capability of the person to serve in that post, he added.
I'm very disappointed with his statement.
Thank you. What did you...
A honorable member of parliament who has 20 years
experience under his belt.
I think he could expand this better. What he's trying to say is that they didn't give him that because of this, but you see the appointing authority looked at this and this, but because this is there, we did not do this. He's just trying to play
around. He's playing around.
The truth is that they might not have given him that post because of what he did in 2017. They might have given it to him because of his expertise.
On merit.
On merit, 20 years experience, and what he can do. But you also have to put into the fact that this comes after he, you know, he tabled that bill.
Thank you. After 2017.
Probation. He might have been a minister
on
of local government on trial. You understand?
Judge your lawyer.
The appointing authority is saying, look, you want to be minister, fine. Do this.
So literally it was like the icing on the
cake. Yeah. So like, you know, do this, give it to me, and you have the post.
Let's get into more shout-outs.
That's quite sad. Anyway, I'm sending shout-out to the Bishop of Rwenzori Diocese, that is Mr. Ruben Kisembo. Now, the Bishop of Rwenzori Diocese, Ruben Kisembo, has pardoned three priests who were suspended in 2017 on allegations of sex scandals and abuse of office. Now, the pardon came during a church service at St. Elizabeth Chapel of Chebambe Girls yesterday in Fort Portal Town. The priests are Reverend Joel Manyindo, Reverend Felix Bataringaya, and Reverend Paul Mbusa Kinyerere. They all appeared in church to ask for forgiveness before Christians and the bishop. Now, the Rwenzori Diocese Tribunal and a Church of Uganda sat on November 28th, received the request of three suspended priests and decided to pardon them, but they will be working under probation. That is, of course, Bishop Kisembo saying. Now, since 2017, the priests have been requesting the diocese tribunal and the church for a pardon. Bishop Kisembo said the priests will work for unspecified probation in the newly appointed places, but would be allowed to conduct church baptisms and weddings. The bishop asked Christians to welcome the priests back, saying since they had been forgiven by the church, they need to keep watching them as they serve their probation.
Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. I hope that they, you know, respected the laws of the land before God gave them some mercy.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to shout out this morning to none other than Jeff Ocheng, Bessie J's look-alike. Why? Because Jeff Ocheng met the former Forum for Democratic Change FDC leader, FDC former leader, Dr. Chiza Bessie J. Again, Ocheng is much teased for resembling Bessie J, and they first met in 2014. The two first met following after a New Vision story of 22-year-old Kenyan photojournalist searching for his father. Ocheng said, for years I had been with the question of whether I was Besigye's son or not, giving the resemblance. Ocheng, who traveled all the way from Kenya to have a chance to meet Besigye again during the 15th anniversary celebrations of FDC at Namboli National Stadium, managed to hook up with his look-alike again. Though we did not discuss much, he pledged to continue to contact me. That's according to Ocheng. But you see, I'd like to say, you know, everyone, you have a lookalike in the seven.
It's called a doppelganger.
That's me right there. You know, you could think I was at Akwanjula and then I decided to go to studio and take a picture.
No, that's not you. That's Ikudzu.
Exactly.
Yeah, they look alike.
No, they do not.
Yeah, they do.
Are you sure?
Have you met Willis's nose?
Same head, just
but
like Kudzu.
Have you met Willis's nose?
Has a smaller eyes. You know, just like they say, I look like Jedina. Yeah. Anyway, let's move away from that. It's very unfortunate Willis did not put my picture right there. But yeah, that's what people say. For that point, we are going to go into
Zadana,
a very short break.
The broke version.
When we do get back, of course, we'll be finding out what is making headlines in the Press Digest.